Gold means different things to different people. If you ask a scientist, they might tell you that gold is an element. A jeweler might tell you that gold is a specific type of jewelry. A geologist might tell you that gold is a metal found in the earth. And a banker might say gold is a form of money. Regardless of your definition, we've all fantasized about wearing a nice chunk of gold. But have you ever wondered where those breathtaking pieces of jewelry come from? Well, sit back and relax, because today we'll be walking through the enchanting process of gold creation. Gold is an old, rare, precious metal that, according to the National Mining Association, was first discovered around 4000 BC in civilizations now known as modern-day Eastern Europe. Perhaps someone or a group of people were bathing in a stream one day, and their eyes caught something shiny and beautiful. So they decided to find more and keep using it. Because of its luster, gold was first used to create things such as jewelry and idols for worship. Some cultures also used gold as offerings to their gods during festivals. The first people to use gold as a medium of exchange was the ancient Empire of Egypt, around 1500 BC. Gold is still a strong marker of monetary value, and many countries peg their currencies to gold because of how stable the value is. But what most people think about when they hear the word gold is the different exquisite jewelry designs that can be made from it. And that's because gold is not just beautiful, it's also rare and expensive. Like any other rare metal, gold is obtained from the earth. The purest form of gold is what we call 24-karat gold. And before you start searching for a place to order 24-karat gold, you should know that in its purest form, gold is soft and very malleable, making it difficult to use for creating jewelry, at least not jewelry that can be worn on a daily basis. Because of that, jewelers often have to mix gold with other metals such as copper, zinc, and silver. This mixture is called a gold alloy. The type of metal used in making a gold alloy determines the color of the gold. That's why you have yellow gold, white gold, and rose gold. So yellow gold is not purer or more authentic than other colors of gold. For example, 18-karat gold simply means that the ratio of gold to other metals is 18 parts gold and 6 parts other metals, regardless of the color. So while 24-karat gold jewelry does exist, it may not be practical for everyday wear because of its fragility. That's why most people prefer 18-karat gold. After gold is extracted from the earth, it must be refined and molded into any exquisite design the manufacturer wants. Several methods are used in refining gold, such as the carbon in pulp method. Carbon in pulp is the process of adding activated carbon to a cyanide slurry, a mixture of cyanide and gold-bearing materials or rocks. After the activated carbon has been added, it absorbs the dissolved gold to the activated carbon. At that point, the gold can then be extracted. Amalgamation is the process of adding mercury to gold particles found in sediments or crushed ore. This mixture, comprising about 50% mercury and 50% gold, is called the amalgam. The mixture is heated long enough for the mercury to evaporate, leaving the refined gold behind. Other methods include cyanidation and flotation. Any number of these processes can be combined to refine gold jewelry, though one method is usually enough. Once the gold has been adequately refined, artisans then smelt the gold to create different spectacular jewelry designs. However, working with gold is a different ballgame entirely compared to working with other metals. As a result, artisans are usually encouraged to first practice with other less expensive and less complicated metals before using gold. So if you're thinking of becoming a jeweler, an excellent place to start practicing is using something like copper. As you get more experienced, you can then move on to silver and then gold. Different methods can be used to manufacture gold jewelry. One of them is gold casting. Gold casting uses computer-aided design, or CAD software, to design the wax model using a 3D printer. The first step is to create a mold with the desired jewelry design. Next, the mold is filled with liquid hot wax, which is left to cool down and harden. Once hardened, the artisan adds a plaster to the hardened wax to maintain the shape of the wax jewelry. This process is called investment casting. The artisan can now heat the jewelry in a furnace until it's melted and drained from the plaster, leaving the plaster hollow. Next, the artisan melts the gold in temperatures ranging from 1,617 degrees Fahrenheit to 2,006 degrees Fahrenheit, depending on which gold alloy was used. The space is then filled with molten gold, ensuring that the gold reaches every part of the plaster evenly, also known as casting. To ensure even spreading of the gold, artisans can use different methods, such as centrifugal casting, vacuum-assisted casting, or pressure casting. The gold is then left to cool. Once cool, the artisan polishes the gold casting until what's left is an exquisite piece of gold jewelry. Another method used in manufacturing gold jewelry is the die striking method. This is a quick method used in creating lightweight, delicate gold jewelry. The artisan first imprints large dies with a picture or design they want to make. Using die cutting machines, they cut out the designs, which are now called die cuts. Then, they shape thin sheets of gold using those large die cuts and polish them until they form the jewelry the artisan has in mind. Die striking is commonly used in creating 18-karat gold rings or gold antique lockets, and it's very useful for manufacturers who want to create large numbers of the same shape of jewelry very fast. The next method for manufacturing gold jewelry is electroforming. Electroforming is an old, well-established method of making gold jewelry. It involves making wax copies of the jewelry design and covering them in a thin, electrically charged metal coating. The artisan then places the wax copies in an electrically charged liquid that contains small amounts of gold. The gold particles stick to the wax copies in multiple layers, and the artisan ensures a little hole is left. Through this hole, the wax is melted and drained, leaving the formed gold jewelry, which is then polished to perfection. The electroforming process is used to create large, bold, and light gold jewelry that also looks splendid. Another advantage of this method is that it can be used to make 24-karat gold jewelry since it supports delicate structures. Over the centuries, gold jewelry manufacturing has become easier as machines for gold jewelry production advance every day. But before the machines, gold jewelry, and in fact all jewelry, was handcrafted. While most manufacturers use machines to produce jewelry in bulk, some still pride themselves on creating handmade jewelry. Some people prefer handmade gold jewelry because of the amount of craft and personal touches that go into making it. This brings us to our next method of creating gold jewelry, the handmade method. The first step is for the artisan to heat the gold carefully until it becomes a molten block that can be gradually molded. The artisan then transfers the molten block to an iron wheel, where they roll it into sheets or wires that will form the different parts of the finished piece of jewelry. Next, the artisan creates the base of the jewelry and also the clasps that will hold the gemstone, if one is needed. When all the jewelry parts are ready, the artisan solders them or joins them together. Throughout this process, the artisan continues polishing and cleaning the jewelry to eliminate any debris or impurities that could gather in the areas that are difficult to reach. Next, they precisely place each gemstone in its clasp using a setter. The design and quality of a handcrafted piece of gold jewelry depends on the experience and skill of the artisan. However, when done right, handcrafted jewelry is very valuable and can be a priceless family heirloom. So what do you think? Is manufacturing gold jewelry easy enough that you might want to give it a try sometime? Or would you rather leave it to the manufacturers and walk into a store to be dazzled with infinite options of jewelry designs? Let us know in the comments. Also, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this.